Hi friends, welcome to episode 8 of our UAE Corporate Tax series. As we understand, UAE tax is not limited to UAE based individual and business entities, but foreign companies may also be subject to UAE corporate tax if such foreign company is having permanent establishment in the UAE. To determine, PE concept is used to determine when and if and when a company has established sufficient presence in any foreign countries wherein the business profit of such foreign companies is liable to be taxed. Generally, a country only has the right to tax the business of a foreign company only in case when such foreign company is having permanent establishment in such country. The corporate tax regime in the UAE may result in taxing foreign companies that conduct trade or business in the UAE through a permanent establishment in UAE. Article 14 provides foreign company to have PE in the UAE in three categories. Category 1 provide for fixed place PE, wherein a foreign company having a fixed or permanent place in the UAE through which it is conducting any business, such fixed place may be considered as constituted as PE for foreign company. Second is agency PE, wherein a person based in UAE habitually exercising an authority to conduct a business or business activity in the UAE on behalf of such foreign company. So a third is any other form of nexus in the UAE of any foreign company. So the nexus rule is yet not provided in the law, and it is yet to be notified by the cabinet. Moving to the fixed place PE, any fixed place like branch, office, workshop, factory, or any other real estate may constitute PE for a foreign company if such place is used for revenue generating activity. Any fixed place which is a place of management, wherein management and commercial decisions that are necessary for the conduct of business of the foreign company may also constitute PE for such foreign company. Any fixed place or any installation or structure for the exploration or renewal or non-renewal resources can also be constitute PE of a foreign company in the UAE. Any mine, an oil or gas well or a quarry or any other place of extraction of natural resource, including vessel and structure based in the UAE, may also constitute PE for the foreign companies. Any fixed place PE may also constitute in a building site or in a construction project or in a place of assembly or installation or any other related supervisory activities in connection with the construction project may also constitute PE, provided such construction activity or building activity has been carried out not for less than 6 months. While computation of this threshold of 6 months, all the connected activity like supervisory activity, assembling activity, or all other kind of connected activity needs to be computed altogether. If we read the installation PE, it is broadly in line with UAE model convention, and it provides assembly and supervisory, which is akin to the provisions of UN model convention, and they are not there in the OECD model convention. The period of threshold of 6 months is also in line with the UN model, as against 12-month period provided in the OECD model convention. Certain fixed places may not where from where there are the core revenue generating activities are not carried out by foreign companies. Such fixed places would not constitute PE. Such fixed places which are used solely for the purpose of storing, display, or delivering of goods, stock holding, or procurement function, or for collecting information, such place would not constitute PE in the UAE. Activity or any other place from where activity of preparatory or auxiliary nature has been carried out, then such place would also be excluded from the constitution of PE. As such, the law do not provide the definition of preparatory and auxiliary activities, and neither any exhaustive or non-exhaustive list is provided. However, in general term, preparatory means any activities which is in contemplation to the revenue core revenue generating activity, and auxiliary is something which is in support of the revenue generating activity, but they are not actual revenue generating activity. It is to be noted that the law provides that exclusion of preparatory and auxiliary or non-revenue generating activity, which I just discussed, not apply to any fixed or permanent place in the UAE that is used or maintained by non-resident person if same non-resident person or its related party carries on any core business or business activity at the same place or another place in the UAE along with non-core activity. So if there is a place which is used by the a particular group for the core revenue generating activity as well for the non-core generating activity, in all those cases the activities will be combined, and overall activity resulting from the combination of permanent from revenue generating activity and core revenue generating activity would be seen. And if a cohesive business operation is found, then the exemption or exclusion of preparatory auxiliary would not be available in that case. Agency PE, the second category, as I mentioned, that is the agency PE or DAP, which we understand is the general language. A person to be considered dependent agent and constitute DAP in the UAE for a foreign company if any of the following conditions are met. Either such person or agent habitually conclude contracts in the UAE on behalf of non-resident principal, or such person habitually negotiate contracts that are concluded by the non-resident person without the need of material modification by the non-resident principal. So on fulfillment of either of the condition, the agent may constitute dependent agent PE for the non-resident principal. However, an agent cannot be considered as dependent agent unless such agent act exclusively or almost exclusively on the behalf of non-resident principal, or if such agent is legally and economically independent from the non-resident principal. In that case, the agent would not be considered as dependent agent, and foreign company would not constitute PE in the UAE. As I mentioned, the third category is the nexus-based PE, which is yet not notified and final rules are awaited. It is expected that the nexus-based PE may be rolled out on the basis of amount A of Pillar 1 under two-pillar solution by WIPS, wherein generally in-scope companies are very large and most profitable entities globally. Further, Clause 7 of the Article 14 provides certain instances wherein PE would not constitute in the AE for a foreign company. The first instance provided is mere presence of a natural person in the UAE do not constitute PE if such presence is due to temporary and exceptional situation. Again, the definition of temporary and exceptional situation is not provided, and support should be borrowed from the OECD Model Convention and UN Model Convention and other global guidance. Similarly, if employee of a foreign company is traveling to the UAE, such employee of a foreign company would not constitute PE in the UAE if such employee is not carrying out any kind of revenue generating activity, and such foreign company is not having any UAE sourced income. If both conditions are met, then if both conditions are met, then only then the PE would not be constituted in the UAE. So that was about the law which has been breakdown in the seven clauses of the Article 14. Now the key takeaways from the law so far First, as of now, and no specific rules or clause in relation to the e-com specific business or e-com digital PE or digital PE concept is not there in the law. Design is in alignment with the OECD model convention and UN model convention, and MLI language has also been brought in many places. So respective commentaries can also be sought for the interpretation purpose. While constituting PE, the bilateral tax treaty provisions cannot be ignored and to be read in parallel with the Article 14. Provisions of bilateral tax treaty would likely to override the provisions of federal decree law as per the guidance provided. Further, one important aspect would be the applicability of transfer pricing provisions, whether if a foreign company is constituting PE in UAE, and that the transaction between such PE and foreign company would be subject to transfer pricing, UAE transfer pricing or not, that needs to be checked upon. That needs further evaluation. Thank you very much, and I hope you like this video.